Back to some of the most iconic images you've ever seen. Photos, say in Life magazine, on the cover, between the pages over the years. Many of those photos were taken by our next guest, John Loengard, and he has a new exhibit starting tomorrow at the International Photography Hall of Fame. He took that one. Yeah, he took that one of the Beatles. And it's happening in St. Louis. It's called Moment by Moment, featuring some of Life magazine's most incredible images, like the ones you're looking at. And we welcome Mr. Loengard in here today. That, I mean, I could just stare at those all day. Black and white, a dying art. Welcome to St. Louis.
Thank you, Maggie.
We are talking about photography, and you know, everybody's a photographer now because of the phones they have in their pocket. But taking iconic shots like these, the ones we know, the ones we grew up with, do you feel like that is your legacy?
Well, I hope it's my legacy,
yeah.
Because I don't think I have any other. And it's nice to think that you might have a legacy.
And definitely have folks who might emulate your work as well, folks who want to do this for a living. Do you think these types of photos in magazines like Life, people are at home going, what's Life magazine? It's a dying thing, magazines and photos,
yes,
in magazines.
Yes, it's a dead thing, I think, now.
It's
pretty
dead.
Pretty much, yeah. Life magazine used to come every week. It was a large page that you held in your hand, and that was all you could see, was the pages and the photographs on it. It was the first magazine in this country to tell stories through pictures, and that was terribly important throughout its...
And we're talking about... You had the 1963 photo of Medgar Evers' widow and son at his funeral. 1961, the photo of Judy Garland at City Hall. American painter Georgia O'Keeffe in New Mexico. The Beatles, as we saw in the swimming pool. What is your favorite photo that you've ever shot, that you've ever taken?
What would be my favorite child?
Yeah.
Well, I'm not going to tell you.
No?
Yeah.
Like your favorite child. You just don't mention
it. But I'll tell you, my favorite subject possibly would be Georgia O'Keeffe.
Yeah.
And she had been married to a very famous photographer named Alfred Stieglitz, who was passed before I came. And she knew how to pose. It was extraordinary. She was extraordinarily graceful and extraordinarily willing to be photographed.
Wonderful. Now, we talked before we came on the air about the, you know, film and film strips and 35 millimeter and digital. Are you mad at digital photography?
I'm mad that it didn't come 40 years earlier.
You think it's a wonderful tool?
Oh, everybody who worked when I was working just hits their forehead and say, oh, how much easier everything would have been.
And now you talk about taking photos on your phone. You would think somebody like our guest would say, no, no, no. You love the idea.
I do, absolutely. Oh, I think it's wonderful. In the first place, because the best camera is the one that you have with you.
Right.
You always have the phone with you. But it takes absolutely marvelous pictures.
Isn't that incredible? I'd love to learn more. And you can learn more from him. It's John Loengard. He's going to present a special speaking engagement, Moment by Moment. That's happening tomorrow from 1:30 to 2:30 at the International Photography Hall of Fame, and that's in St. Louis. There is a fee for the lecture, and we'll have all the information on our website. Man, I could chat with you forever. Thank you so much for coming in.
Wonderful. Thank
Appreciate
you.
It. Enjoy your time in St.
Thank
Louis.
You.
Time to check on this terrible weather. We did not bring some great weather for our guest, Bridget.